Everybody, we're here today to talk about the Het. And the Het is really a beautiful letter. The Het is the eighth letter of the Hebrew alphabet, and therefore, not therefore, but and means, has a meaning as a numerical value of eight. It means life. It makes a sound like the CH in Bach. My favorite explanation of the way to make that sound is from Lawrence Kushner's book, Sefer Otiyot, The Book of Letters. I highly recommend that book. It is just, the reference will be below this video. And it's just the most beautiful book. It's, the calligraphy is just amazing. And all the explanations are also written in the calligraphy. It's just a beautiful book. That was my first book that I saw on the letters, and I just fell in love with it. So, sorry for the interruptions. The truck just went by. Anyway, you just ignore those. Just part of the video. Part of the video. So, the Het is normally made, traditionally made, of two vavs, which each mean two vavs. Each vav is six, so therefore it equals 12. But Lurie of the 16th century, he was a Kabbalistic master. He came up with the idea that he thought that the letter was actually made of a zion and a vav. And before I start talking about that, this is the time to pause the video and go get your materials for drawing your Het. You just pause it, you take as long as you want, of course, if it's paused, and then you can draw with a pencil or crayons or acrylics, whatever. You can draw your own Het or trace it or whatever. Anyway, I'm going to show you a few of my Hets. And then you can get the idea. Oh, I have to finish the Lauria story. I am just perfectly imperfect. Anyway, so the Lauria story is that that if it's made of a Zion, 7, and a Vav, 6, I just love the letters, then it equals 13. 7 and 6 are 13. And video was a little dark. Anyway, which equals a had, which is, that's not a had, this is a had, which is Aleph is 1, Het is 8, and Dalet. It's not a good, not a very good Dalet. But anyway, the Dalet has a numerical, they all have a numerical, those were all numerical values, and the Dalet has a numerical value of 4, so 1, 8, and 4 equal 13. And the significance of that is that that means 1. Echad means 1 in Hebrew. So God is 1. And that is related to the Yud-Heh-Vav-Heh name of God, which is this. And this is the Yud. This is the Heh. Part of it's here. Over the Vav, which is there, and this is the last hay. And the numerical value of that is 26, which is related to the 13. It's half, it's doubled of the had. So it really has a wonderful meaning. So now I'm gonna show you some of my Hets. This is a good, very clear Het. So it has this here, this is the this is the Zion, and then it goes over here with the Vav. So that's cool. And this is the Het, look at the face. This is the Het looking at that skier with kind of a quizzical look on its face. Is this guy really gonna make it down? And this is the Het indicating indicating creation because of the flowers, etc. And this is the fet in a garden or whatever. And this is another fet with the vine outlining the fet, indicating creation again. And this is just a stylized hat. And this is a big hat. This hat, it's missing the top of the hat. I don't know why it came to me like this, but anyway, and there's the vav, but it's missing the other half. But here's, you can see this part of the design. Anyway, if you go close, you can see that all the letters are on that tree, which of course indicates life. It's really cool. Says she modestly. But I do love this particular one. Anyway, so now hopefully you have drawn your own het, and we're going to do a short meditation. So anyway, here's the meditation. So you want to, if you've drawn your own het, it should be really nice. You can concentrating on your own het. In this meditation, I'm going to tell you about the het that comes to me this time. And the het that comes to me this time is in green, against kind of a green jungly, I don't like jungles, jungly background. But the front of it is very pretty. It's green, it has a green outline, and inside it has different colors of green in little swirls. I should paint that. Well, this is how I get my paintings, is right here when I meditate. So I'm going around and I'm going to look at the back of the hut. And it is a jungle. Ugh. Well, and the jungle is right here, so I'm going to push. You can do anything in meditation, so I'm going to push the jungle way back so I have grass, a hill of grass that I can walk down with little flowers on it, little wild flowers of lavender and yellow and orange and pink and red. It's almost like a blanket. Well, now that would be pretty good paint. So I'm walking down this hill. It's a pretty good sized hill. And I finally get to the jungle. And I'm not going in the jungle because I don't like jungles. Ugh. They have creepy crawlies in them and they're gooey. And they have insects. I don't like those either particularly. So anyway, I'm going to stay out here where it's nice and comfortable on this beautiful field of grass with all these little wildflowers in it. And I'm going to look into the jungle. So, oh my goodness, oh my goodness, oh my god, there are wonderful parrots. I didn't expect parrots. They're just beautiful, and they're all different colors. They're all primary colors. They're orange and red, and this one is like turquoise and a dark turquoise and white. And there's another one that's green with a blue head. And there's another one that's orange, all orange, well, and kind of peach. They're just beautiful. And that's just some of them. They're just, one's royal blue with a white head. Wow, well, that was a surprise. Now, that's something wonderful about the jungle. I still don't want to go in there, but, but I like watching these parrots. And they'd sit for a while, and then they get up, and they get up. They fly away to another branch, and then they're all chattering at each other like they're talking. Well, isn't that interesting? That was unexpected. And there's a bush with these big red flowers on them. And not a bush, a plant with these huge what do you call it? Leaves. If you choose to look at the jungle or wherever you are and you just sit quietly, there's almost some music to the whole thing. So I'm going to sit here and enjoy that music for a little bit. And the colors. Well, we need to be start coming back to this, to the room you're in. I've been meditating for over almost 40 years, and I could sit here all day, but this tape would then go on forever, and you'd be very bored. So let's start back to this room, and I'm going to walk up this hill. And I didn't realize that the back of the hat was a mirror for the top of the jungle, so I can see the sky in spots. But of course, I was sitting at the base of the jungle. Jungles are really, really tall. At least my jungle is. So I'm going to walk underneath the hut and come back to this room. And then I'm going to wiggle my toes and wiggle my hands and bring myself back completely. Well, that was very nice and unexpected. I saw a blue bush, not a bush, a blue leafy thing with white flowers. That was very pretty. I didn't know they had blue. Well, maybe they don't actually have blue jungle plants with white flowers. They're huge, the flowers. Well, the plant's huge. So we're back here now, and all the references that I used to research these letters and find the meanings, etc., will be listed underneath this video. And if you wish to see more of, or rather, my paintings of the Chat, they will be up on Jewish Meditation, the Facebook page of Jewish Meditation and Practical Spirituality, and also on Hebrew Letters by Sarah Leah. Yeah, so this is really fun. I just love sharing the letters. I just love it. So anyway, thank you so much for joining me, and I will see you next week when we talk about the Tet.